For example, one more similar type of questions is like, in an examination, one student got some 33 or like some 32% of total number of marks, and he failed by some 8 marks. Another student who got like 35%, he got 16 marks more than pass mark. Okay, then we need to find the like a total marks, pass marks percentage. So how to calculate this one? Okay, just observe here. First, write down this question. One student got 32% and failed by 8 marks. Another student got 35%, he got 16 marks more than pass mark. So this is the like a condition. One got 32% of total words and he like a failed by 8 marks. Another student who got 35% of total marks and he got 16 marks more than the pass mark. Now we need to find the like total number of marks, pass marks percentage, and like passing marks also. Okay, so this one also like a general method is, so what we will do, so total marks we will take as some x, total marks I will take as x. Okay, in that like first student got 32% of the total marks and he failed by 8 marks. Please remember, one student got like one student failed by 8 marks means, so for that marks if you are adding 8 marks he will get pass marks. Agree? He got 32% and he failed by 8 marks means if you are adding 8 marks that will become like a pass marks. So 32% he got and he failed by 8 marks, so I am adding 8 marks so that he will get pass marks. Agree? Same way, another student who got 35%, he got 16 marks more than pass mark. So that means for this person, like suppose if you are subtracting 16 marks from that, even that is also equal to pass marks only. See, another student who got 35% of total marks, he got 16 marks more, so I am subtracting 16, that is also equal to pass marks only. Yes? Now see, both are pass marks only. So you can equate these two. So the same thing I am doing now. So 32 by 100 x plus 8 equal to 35 by 100 minus 16. Agree? So now just bring all one side. So this one, if you bring this side, it will become 3x by 100, because 35 minus 32, you will get 3x by 100, and 8 plus 16, 24. Okay? So from this, x value equal to 24 into 100 by 3. Nothing but 800 you will get. Clear? So if you know like total marks has like 800, okay, so if you know total marks has like 800, then we need to find the like a pass marks. So to find the pass marks, substitute this x value in this or in this. Okay, substitute like 800 in this one and add 8, you will get like pass marks. Okay, how much? So 32 by 100 into 800 plus 8, so nothing but plus 8, you will get 266. These are the like pass marks. And passing percentage, if you want pass percentage, nothing but this 266 divided by 800 into 100, so how much you will get? 33% you will get pass percentage. Clear? So this is the general procedure for like if you are doing in a traditional method, this is the method. But the same thing only you can do even through the like shortcut also, like in so hard, like in seconds only you can solve this question. That is how, just we will see. So observe carefully. Shortcut. So here the total marks I am taking as like this. This is the like total marks, 100%. Okay. We don't know the pass percentage, so somewhere I am taking this is as a like a pass mark. So pass marks I am taking somewhere in between. Okay. So one got like a 32% and he failed by 8 marks. So definitely that will be less than the pass marks. Agree? So if this is a pass mark, he failed by 8 marks, means compulsory somewhere it will be here. 32%. Okay. And another student who got 35%, he got 16 marks more. So that means compulsory that this will be more than the pass marks. 35%. Okay. So this one only. Now this person who got 32%, he got how many? 8 marks less than the pass mark. And another student who got 35%, he got 16 marks more than the pass mark. Correct. Now, so from 32 to 35% means like total how much percent is the difference? 32 to 35, it is 3%. 32 to 35, it is 3%. What about like marks? Here 8 and here 16. So total 24 marks is the difference. That means now 8% equal to 24. So 1% value will be equal to 24 by 3. Nothing but 8. Clear? If 1% is 8, 100% 800. That is the answer which we did last time. Clear? So that means like 100% is nothing but like total marks. Total marks equal to 100. And suppose if you want like a pass mark percentage, see from this only 8 marks equal to 1%, correct? So 8 marks equal to 1%. That means what about 16 marks 2% are here also. This 8 marks equal to 1%. So 32% plus 1. Nothing but 33%. 32 plus 1 are 16 marks equal to 2%. 35 minus 2. That is also equal to 33 only. Clear? Or if you want like a pass marks, same. Like 1% equal to 8 marks. So 32% means 32 into 8. Okay. So 33 into 8 directly, 264 you will get. Clear? So this is how you can solve this kind of problems. Done? Okay. So okay, and one more thing, here we have like one person got less than pass mark, another one got like more than pass mark. So we are like adding these two values. Suppose if they give like both got less than pass marks only, or if both got like more than pass mark, then that will see like one problem now. See here, one person got 30% and he failed by 48 marks. Another student got 40% and he also failed by 18 marks. Okay. Now here both like failed by 8 marks only. So this normal procedure you know how to do. Okay. That is like by assuming. So total marks as X. Okay. So one who got 30% means 30% of total X. So failed by 48. So if you add 48, you will get pass marks. Another one got 40%, so he also failed by 18 marks, so for him you need to add 18 marks. This is also equal to pass marks only. Okay, so now you can equate these two values, so you will get, so 30x by 100 plus 48 equal to 40x by 100 plus 18. So if you bring this side, 10x by 100 equal to, you will get 30, so x equal to 300. This is one thing. Okay, the same thing like if you want to do in a shortcut, so what you can do, same like that only you can take. See, total marks 100, somewhere, it is like a pass marks. Okay, so one got 30% and failed by 48. Take somewhere here it is 30%, failed by 48 marks. One more student got 40%, that means it is more than this, but failed by, so less than this pass mark. So somewhere here you can take 40%. So this is 18 marks. Okay. Now from 30 to 40 it is 10% only. Okay, 10%. Okay. If you are taking from 30 to 40, so marks also from 30 to 40 only you need to take. So, but we don't know this value. So for that, from this total, if you subtract this one, we will get the remaining value. From this total, if you subtract this one, we will get the remaining value. So nothing but, see, 48 minus 18 if you do, that is nothing but 30 you will get. So 10% value equal to 30. So 1%, 3, 100%, 300. Clear? So here also, so 3 marks equal to 1%. Okay, to get pass marks percentage, see, for 18 marks, 6%. So 18 marks, 6%. So pass percentage equal to this 40 plus 6, nothing but 46%. So to get pass marks also, if you want, that 46 into this one, 3 you can do, so that you will get the pass marks. Clear? Fine. So these are the like some basic types of problems which we can see like in percentages. Okay, hope you enjoyed watching this one, and like in the next class also we will continue with the same percentages only with some more different types of problems. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day.